Good morning. In today's system programming and compiler constraint lecture, we will see the code optimizations. The code optimization is the techniques wherein the final code generated and it is transferred to the machine is not a final. Before transferring to it to the machines, we will optimize this code. That means we have to minimize the codes, find out the errors, and then we will send to machines. So as you know, there is a source program or source code. It is given to the compiler and we will get the object code. Now this object code is optimized by using some techniques. So what is the code optimization actually? The code optimization is the technique used by the compiler to improve the execution's efficiency of the generated object code. So this is called as the code optimizations. Now this code optimizations is of two types. Types of code optimization. So there is a two types, that is number one is called as a machine independent, and second one is a machine dependent. So machine independent, in machine independent optimization can be performed independently of the target machines for which the compiler is generating code. That is, the optimization are not tied to the target machine specific platform or the language. Example of the machine independent optimization are the elimination of the loop, invariant computations, induction way eliminations, and elimination of the common sub expression. On the other hand, machine dependent optimization require knowledge of the target machine and attempt to generate the object code that will utilize the target machine's registers more efficiently is an example of machine dependent code optimization. Actually, code optimization is the misnomer even after the performing various optimization transformations. There is no guarantee that the generated object code will be optimal. Hence, we are actually performing code improvement. When attempting any optimization transformation, the following criteria should be applied. The criteria for optimizations. Criterion for code optimization will contain: number one, the optimizer should capture most of the potential improvement. It should capture most of potential improvements without an reasonable amount of efforts. Number second point, the optimizer should be such that a minimum meaning of the source program is preserved. Meaning of source program should preserve. Third point, the optimizer should on average reduce the time and space expended by the object code. Time and space should be reduced in optimization. So this time and space should be reduced. Now let us see the optimizations. So let us see the first loop optimizations. Loop optimization is the most variable machine independent optimization because a program's inner loop are good candidate for improvements. The important loop optimization are elimination of the loop invariant computation and elimination of the induction variable. A loop invariant computation is one that computes the same value every time a loop is executed. Therefore, moving such computation outside the loop leads to the reduction in the execution time. Induction variable are those variables used in the loop. Their values are in the lockstep and hence it may be possible to eliminate all except one. The second is eliminating loop invariant computations. So to eliminate a loop invariant computation, we first identified the invariant computations and then improve the outside loop if the move does not lead to the change in the program's meaning. Identification of the loop invariant computation requires the detection of the loops in the program. Whether a loop exists in the program or not depends on the program's control flow. Therefore, required a control flow analysis. For loop detections, a graphical representation called program flow graph shows how the controls is flowing in the graph and the program and how the control is being used. To obtain such graph, we must participate the intermediate code into basic code. The required identification leader statement which also follows. The first statement is a leader statement. The target of the conditional or unconditional go to is the leader. A statement that immediately follow a conditional go to is a leader. So that means we should require the leader statement. So what is the leader statement? So leader statement, the statement follows go to is leader statement. So in this way, leader statement we will be finding. Now the next is algorithm to partition the three address code into the basic blocks. So now algorithm to partition three address code into basic blocks. So let us see this algorithm to partition three address code into basic blocks. So what will be the algorithm? Let us see with some examples. So examples is consider packed x int f equal to 1 for I equal to 2 I less than or equal to x I plus plus f times I and return fx. So now for this we have to calculate the tag. That means three address code, and three address code remaining for this program is, now the three address code representation, tag representation will be number 1 f equal to 1, number 2 I equal to 2, number 3 statement if I less than or equal to x go to some things, number 4 f into I, number 5 t1 we assume that is equal to I plus 1,